Why Water Baptism, Part 21. I'm Professor Hannes Redlinghuis of the First Assembly of Yafashua in South Africa, Montana, Pretoria. Should you require any information about the books which I've written, which is quite a large number in English and in Afrikaans, please contact us at 0722-367-124. That's on a plus 27 international code. Or very easy, just go to my website, https://yahvah.co.za, all small letters. If this is the first time that you are going to participate in the study, Why Water Baptism, I urge you to go to part one and start from the beginning, because you have missed quite a bit of information up to this stage. It's also very, very important to subscribe to the channel in order to be notified about all the other studies that we are currently busy with, especially our TikTok messages. Please send them around. It's only 3 minutes, but it has a massive impact. Share this link with your friends and family. Make sure that you have pen and paper ready, as well as the 1611 King James Bible at least. Now, I only do these announcements on a Monday from now on. It is very important to know we do not associate ourselves with the following people: any Messianic groups, the Israel Vision groups, the Hebrew Roots movement, the Sacred Name movement, the Yom movement. We are not part of the Jehovah Witnesses or the Seventh-day Adventist churches. We are not affiliated to any church, denomination, group or organization in the world. Please take note what I've just said. We are not affiliated to any church, denomination, group or organization in the world. Instead, we are only an end-time Bible study group functioning throughout the world. And we are trying to function throughout the world. We are mainly using the ancient Hebrew Sacred Name Bible according to the 1816 restoration of the original Sacred Name Bible, the Rottenham version, which was translated by Dr. Joseph Briant Rottenham in 1860. This makes it one of the oldest Hebrew stroke English Bibles that you can find. Should it happen that you would require one, please contact me. I have a couple in stock. According to the original ancient Hebrew Sacred Name Bible, the restoration of the original Sacred Name Bible, the Rottenham version, the name Jesus was originally Yafashua. The name God was originally Elohim or Hashem. The name Lord was originally Yahvah. The name of the Holy Spirit was originally the Ruach HaKodesh. We are not Christians. We don't refer to ourselves as Christians, but we refer to ourselves as Yafist, according to 1 Peter 4 verse 16 in the Restoration Bible. So were the disciples and the apostles of Yafashua, the followers named, they were known as Yafist. I trust this study will be a blessing unto you in the name of Yafashua. Hallelujah. Welcome to Breakfast with Prof. Hannes. Why Water Baptism? Hallelujah. What a study. What a study. We had a couple of calls of people that says, Prof, I never realized how we were blinded by church dogma and teachings. And that's unfortunately the thing that has happened, which we didn't know. We were trusting other people to lead us, while we didn't really know that they didn't even know. How easy is that? We are looking at the spiritual funeral. Now, I just want to make an announcement here. In these following scriptures, it will be important to know how small letters are used when referring to Yahvah, the creator of heaven and earth, and his son Yafashua, our Redeemer. Meaning small letters when referring to he, referring to the creator of heaven and earth, Yahvah, our Elohim, small letters. I'm just going to mention it, and then you can make it a capital letter in your Bible. We are at Romans 6 verse 5. We're going from there. For if we have planted together, if we have been planted together in the likeness of his death, his small letter, make it a capital letter, Yahushua. If we have been planted together in the likeness of his death. So with other words, by being immersed in the name of Yahushua, we grew equal unto Yahushua in the likeness of his death and resurrection. Let's read the scripture. For if we have been planted together in the likeness of his death, we shall also be in the likeness of his, capital letter, his resurrection. So the one is connected to the other one. As bride of Yahushua, we need to be living in the likeness of Yahushua. And after repentance, the old person of sin needs to be immersed, needs to be buried. What is Romans? What have we learned from Romans 6, verse 1 to verse 5? That we are looking at a spiritual funeral. Where people who came to repentance, who were rapists and pedophiles, and you can call it, when they come to repentance, they need to be buried. They need to be buried so that they can arise in the likeness of Yahushua. Hallelujah. This is what the scripture says. So the moment that I am buried, I grow equal in the likeness of Yahushua. Also in the likeness of his resurrection from the dead. So we were dead. We were living in sin. Sin overwhelmed our lives. Sin was the anchor of our lives. Now we've repented and we need to be buried so that we can also grow in the likeness of his resurrection. And the only way that you can do that is through water immersion in the name of Yahushua. That's why in Acts 2, 36 to 41, on the day of Pentecost, 3,000 souls were immersed in the name of Yahushua. They grew into the likeness of Yahushua. That was the key that Apostle Peter used. On that stage, he wasn't the apostle yet. He was Peter. That was the key that he received. That was the key that he received. The key of the gospel of salvation. The truth of being immersed in the name of Yahushua. To forgiveness of our sin. There's no other way that you can grow into the likeness of Yahushua. Of his death and his resurrection. Now he says in verse 6, knowing this, now you must tighten your seatbelt. Knowing this, that our old man is crucified with him, that he make it a capital H. Knowing that our old man, the old man of sin, the rapist, the child molestator, you can call it what sins you like. That the man is crucified with Yahushua. Do we go and lie on a cross and they eat us or tie us up? No, no, no. But in the likeness as he was crucified. You know what the word says? The word of Yahweh says, he came and he became sin for us. The word says he never knew sin. He did not sin. He, according to Hebrews 7, according to the order of Melchizedek, he did not have to first, as the high priest, offer an offering unto his sin. Like the Old Testament high priest, every year when offering for the sin of the nation, they first had to offer an offering unto themselves because they were sinning. Yahushua. didn't have to do it. The word says that he knew not sin. He wasn't sinful, but he became sin by hanging on a Roman cross. For who? For us. He bare my sorrows and my grievousness, my sickness, my pain, my disappointments. He bore them all on the cross. So what happens here? Knowing this, so this is a revelation. What does it say in verse 6? Knowing this, knowing what? Everything that we studied last week and the week before that. From verse 1 up to verse 6. Knowing what we have experienced until now is a what? Is a revelation. You see, how many times have we just read over these scriptures and it had no impact in our lives? We didn't realize the importance of these scriptures to gel us into one with Yahushua through his blood that he shed for us. Knowing this revelation, that our old man is crucified with him. So we're not going to lie on a cross. He's already died on the cross for us. And the body of sin might be destroyed. That the body of sin might be destroyed. What destroyed my sin? The cross. No, the cross didn't destroy my sin. It's him, the Son of Yahweh, the creator of heaven and earth, that has given his life in order that my body of sin can be destroyed. Through his blood. His, not just his blood, his redemption blood. He gave it freely. Isaiah 53 verse 1 to 8 says, he was like a lamb at the slaughter. He did not even open his mouth. He bore our sickness and our grievousness. We were crucified with him. I want to change the word in him. See how it makes a difference now. Knowing this, that our old man of is crucified in him. In him we are saved. That the body of sin might be destroyed. It's not a might. When I look at the word that I use here, might, it can be, it might, it's possible. No, it has happened. This might is something, when people are uncertain of something, they use the word might and can be, it is possible. But we, as part of the bride of Yahushua, we say that the body of sin has been destroyed 2,000 years ago. Hallelujah. That henceforth we should not serve sin. Once the person has been immersed, henceforth we should not serve sin. We should not participate in sin. Can you remember Romans 6 verse 1? How did it start? It starts with a question. Can you remember? What did Apostle Paul say? Shall we stay in sin so that grace can be about? No. We cannot play with sin. We cannot continue going back into sin, doing sin, living in sin, participating in sin. We can't. We cannot do it. It's like the word says, it's like a dog turning to his own vomiting. And I don't think it's just turning to it, it's licking it. A dog licks everything. A dog even licks its own vomiting. And if we, after we've come to repentance and have been immersed in the name of Yahushua, walking the road of holiness, because that's the third part of it, is repentance, being immersed in the name of Yahushua. With other words, we are having a spiritual funeral. And then after we arose from the water grave, then we need to walk in holiness the rest of our lives. And should it happen that we should fall, and it's like, and you see, some people, you can slip. There's no super holy people, not on this earth. We strive to perfection, we strive work towards holiness. But should it happen that something happens, we have the Holy Spirit, the Ruach HaKodesh, which is watching over us, which is teaching and learning us, and convincing us about sin. And this is what he says here. Knowing this, that the old man is crucified with him, that's Yahushua, that the body of sin might be destroyed. Now, I don't want to say might, have been destroyed, positive. Might says it's something that can happen in the future. Have says it has happened already. That henceforth, we should not serve sins. Henceforth mean walking this road of holiness. We should strive not to do sin, but live according to the word of righteousness in the name of Yahushua. Till tomorrow morning, if Yahweh's will, Maranatha, Yahushua is coming back again. Hallelujah.